డిఎల్ఆర్ ఈరోజు హోప్ అండ్ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ గురించి డిస్కస్ చేద్దాం. టాపిక్ హోప్ అండ్ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ ఏంటంటే, దీస్ ఆర్ టూ వర్డ్స్ విచ్ ఆర్ కామన్లీ యూజ్డ్ ఇన్ అవర్ డే టు డే లైఫ్. ఇట్స్ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఈజియర్, ఎట్ ది సేమ్ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఇస్ కన్ఫ్యూజింగ్, లిటిల్ బిట్ జంబిల్డ్ ఆల్సో. హోప్ అండ్ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ బోత్ ఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ సిమిలర్ మీనింగ్స్, but some difference is there. This I wanted to explain. This hope means positiveness. Hope means positiveness, happiness, and result oriented. The examples are, I hope I will win the cricket match. I hope I will get through the JEE entrance examination. I hope the results will be declared today and I will get the good marks. This is the positive side of a situation or a game or an effort which all of us play. Hope means a sign of expectation in a positive manner. In coming to expect, weather. Today, weather is expected to be little bit thunderstorms, little bit rainy, little bit hot. That expected is not the definite. Probabilities are there. The probabilities may be bleak, the probabilities may be high. So I expect to pass. That means I may pass or I may not pass. It is not the generally negative fact. It is uncertainty. It is uncertainty. This denotes uncertainty. I expect that you will win. That means you aspire him to win the game, but when you say I expect him to win, it means that there are chances that you may win. The differentiation is this: it's not purely positive, it is a chance, probability. So hope and expect are two different words. Hope is a little bit positive side, expect is a chance, but not totally correct, not totally definite nor authentic also. So in most of the cases, when we wish anything, we should always try to say, hope you will win the examination, hope you get the success. If you say expect, I expect you will pass, then the other person may feel little bit disturbed, because the way we say expect, the chances are very, very little. Whether we know about him totally or not, it is not a practice to say I expect you will pass, because let us wish all will get the success. There is no point in saying that I expect. So when you talk to somebody, either your friend or relative or anybody, I hope you should better use, I hope you will get success, I hope you are capable, I hope you can do it, I hope it is possible with you, I hope you only can do. It is an inspiration for him, a motivation for him, not only in the usage of the English, but in having a respect on him and also feeling that he should win the examination or related curricular or etc. Because that positive vibrations will allow him to make the attempt in a hopeful manner rather than in expecting the manner. Because when we say expected, when we talk about expected, when we say about us, we may use expect, because it is a feeling of calmness in us. We never boast of ourselves. Then for us, while using, we can say expect to win. Because even if you know you will win, when you are talking to somebody, if we say expect to win, the other person can understand that he is not saying or boasting himself, is talking to us moderately. So you can understand that there are chances for this gentleman to win or not. These chances are 50-50. So for addressing other people, for our day-to-day communication, we should always say, I hope you will win, I hope you get this success. When somebody asks about us, it is ideal to say, I expect to win, I expect there may be a chance, I expect there is a possibility. This way,
it gives us moderate behavior, and other person also feels that whether you will win or not, and you will have an idea. Even if we are confident that we will get this success, it is not ideal to say, I hope I win, because we don't know how other person receives. Unless there is a more intimacy and attachment, and this what you share with others is not told to somebody else by that man, then you can confidently share as a love and affection, I hope I'll win, I am confident that I'll get it. That confidence level will be bestowed and emphasized much on hope. That's where the confidence level of hope is more than in the expected. So I expect means little chances. So when we address other people, we should always say hope. When we say for us, it is ideal to say chances are there. So this way, it is better that we get the real meaning and people can understand what you feel like selling. So I hope is generally used for wishing an individual or wishing an event or third party. When we say about ourselves, it is ideal to say I expect to win. Even if you are confident, it is ideal to say I expect to win, because you know you may win. But when you address a third party, there are little chances how other person takes. So I expect should never be used when we are addressing to a third party. Although grammar meanings are like this, it is also required to synchronize in the society how to use it, so that people will understand what we talk and it is easy for them to understand and have a good impression on us. Because courtesy costs nothing but pays more dividends. The dividends means respect, we'll get it, and we don't know when other person will get. So since courtesy costs nothing, whenever we address somebody's position or results or examination, I hope you will win. That is a positive sign we need to say and develop, so that there is a amicable and amiable relationship between us. So I am directing the English grammar of the sentences with the present condition of the human behavior in such a way that I hope and expect are both the words which should be used properly depending on the situation. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please do subscribe my channel if you have not yet done. And please share the videos to your friends and relatives and forward also. Thank you so much for watching this.